Praise the Lord.
Praise to the Lord Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Praise to the God the Father, God the Son, and God the Spirit.
Praise be to Jesus.
Praise to the one who came and rescued us from the wrath of God.
Yes, yes.
Praise the one who came and redeemed us.
Yes.
Praise to the one who came and died on the cross for our sins.
Amen.
Bible tells us everyone is sinner. That includes you, that includes me, that includes everyone.
Yeah.
We all a sinner.
Yeah.
And we cannot stand in front of Holy God
yep.
with our good deeds or by ourselves.
No.
We need someone who can represent us, who can stand for us. That will be Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Through His blood on the cross, through His crucifixion, Lord Jesus Christ makes us right with God.
Amen.
Christian scripture is very clear about certain teachings.
Yep.
Bible tells us it is only God whom you blaspheme against.
Yes.
And in the Christian scripture, Jesus has been people try to stone Jesus because he made a claim that he was God.
Yep.
People understood that, religious leaders understood that as Jesus was blaspheming.
Yeah. Yeah.
Therefore, they wanted to kill him.
That's right. That's right. That's right. And that's why, you know, if you read throughout the Gospels, you find that the Pharisees would pick up stones because they were saying, "Who is this man that says, you know, I can forgive sin? Who is this man, you know, that claims to do things only God can do?" Because they understood that this was a major sin to blaspheme. And so we know through scripture that people were blaspheming God from the beginning. Oh, Jesus, yeah. Yes.
And one of the things is important today is blaspheme done by people
yeah.
against God every day today.
Yeah, yeah.
At Speaker's Corner,
yep.
week after week, Islamic Dawatim blasphemes against Lord Jesus Christ.
That's right.
In academic words, people who do not believe in God attacks and blasphemes against Christian God. In a way, they insult Christian God.
That's right.
But nowhere we take stone to stone them.
No.
Nowhere we want to put them in prison because Islamic Dawatim made a false claim about Lord Jesus or insult Lord Jesus Christ.
No.
But blaspheme suddenly changes when we start talking about religion of Islam.
That's right.
Indonesia, we all heard from the news, this lady called Meiliana, she is Buddhist. She was not happy with the how loud was the call to prayer.
It's quite loud though. But go on.
Good, you're not in Indonesia.
It's a good thing I'm not in Indonesia.
So, call to prayer is simply repeat
yeah.
before the prayers for people to stand up and get ready for their prayers.
Mm.
But in Muslim countries, it is very, very loud.
Mm.
It is very, very loud. Doesn't matter you are Muslim or not Muslim, you have to hear it because you don't have alternative.
Mm.
What happens in Indonesia is this lady thinks call to prayer is very loud. She complains about it. What happens when she complains about it? She says that music isn't loud. Think like this. Your next door neighbor
yeah.
is having a birthday party with the teenagers and then you've got very loud music and you're just simply saying that's loud music, I don't want it. Very, very similar things happens in Indonesia. Buddhist woman says that is very loud sound. What happens?
Yeah, I mean, just before I go into that, I mean, the natural inclination is if someone is saying, you know what, the noise coming from your house or the noise that you're making that everybody can hear is too loud, you just say, well, hold on, you know, perhaps you can turn it down, perhaps you might even apologize, perhaps, you know, you may give them some type of reason why, and you just be show them some type of courtesy. That's just the common human decency to react in that way. But what do we have?
Unfortunately,
we're talking about Islam here. And so what they decide to do is to lock up this woman for 18 months.
For what? What is her crime?
For blaspheming Allah.
Not for blaspheming God, for insulting Islam. It has nothing to do with God.
Right.
Because
but that's what they use. Yeah.
It's blaspheming God. So yeah. She tells people, that is very, very loud sound. Mm. I don't want to hear every 5 times a day, every time, all people, there is one God, Muhammad is his prophet. Wake up.
Yeah.
What is the food?
Which is understandable. No, we don't want to hear the
yes. Prayer.
Yeah.
God is Allah is the greatest.
Muhammad is
I believe Muhammad is his messenger, yeah. Blah blah blah. Yeah. Goes on. And then it says, come to prayer. Come to prayer. Come to salvation. Come to salvation.
That would give me a headache.
Do not sleep.
Yeah.
It is time of prayer.
Yeah.
It is time of the prayer.
Yeah.
Do not sleep. And God is greater. There is no but God but Allah.
Yeah.
That's all it says. And woman who do not follow the religion of Islam doesn't want to hear that loud thing for 5 times a day. And she's Buddhist. She's not even Muslim.
Yeah. Mm.
Mm. And in Indonesia. In Indonesia, because it goes as you are insulting Islam when you say, I don't want to hear Islam that loud. Apparently, you end up in prison for 18 months.
Shocking.
18 months.
Shocking. It is shocking.
Freedom of speech.
There's no freedom.
Freedom of expression. There is nothing under the Islam. You can't even say, I don't want that loud music or loud sound. You will be identified as insulting the religion of peace, so-called peace.
Yeah, so that's interesting. So she didn't mock Allah, mock the Prophet. She didn't rip up the Quran or anything like that. She simply expressed.
No, well.
That's fine. I'm just simply just saying things that we would, Muslims usually put to us, oh, we can't leave their Quran on the floor and things like that. But she simply was concerned about
for
the amount
ears.
Of noise. Sorry?
For the sake of the
hearing. She was concerned about her eardrums and she just simply asked, well, hold on, you know, this is making a lot of noise. Is there any way that you can turn it down? Just like any normal human being could do that.
If you ask the crowd, I think everyone would decry that that's a very terrible thing Indonesia has done to this woman to put her in prison for this.
Yes.
If you ask the crowd, everyone would agree.
Absolutely. I'm sure that I put... do we have any Muslims here?
So,
you are Muslim.
Yeah,
okay, so yeah. So did you hear what he said? So what do you think about that?
Can he make your point again?
Hold on, let him answer. He's heard.
Say it again.
But if the government make a mistake,
which is what you get twisted all the time,
make a mistake, what's happening to Islam? Islam is not guilty in this case.
So, what's your name?
That's irrelevant.
Ali.
Yeah, Ali.
Government.
Stop being rude.
You make a mistake in Britain against the rules. That's really not the rules. Not. Mm. Your story, I don't believe it. If it's heaven, security. If it's heaven, that means the government catches your lady because the law sound is loud. Our government, Saudi Arabia, if I
Okay.
Okay, we understand what you said. We understand.
So, Ali, you are from Saudi Arabia. And you, if you make a statement that is called to prayer is so loud, you wouldn't go to prison, according to you, okay? So what is your belief? So he doesn't believe in God, okay? He believes there is no God, okay? So can he, in Saudi Arabia, tell to bring the voice of the Azam down? What will happen to him in Saudi Arabia? Let's say he went to Mecca, and then as people are in charge,
trouble.
he said, there's too much voice here, I cannot deal. Take this Azam, take this call to prayer down. What will happen to this gentleman in Saudi Arabia? Nothing will happen to him. He's free. Okay, let's just clarify this with Islamic teachings, Ali. So what's your name?
Jamie.
So, let me just help you with basic Islam. He does not believe in God. Do you think he is allowed to live in Saudi Arabia?
Yeah.
Do you think he is allowed to go to Mecca? Answer is no.
You're lying.
He can't even go to Mecca. He can't even practice freedom of traveling the world. Freedom of travel. Movement. He can't even practice that. He can go to Las Vegas. But
yeah, but it's the same point. It's the same point, yeah.
If he was a Buddhist, he's very close to Buddhism, can he go to Mecca? No. Can he write a letter to the Saudi Arabian government and then say, I concern for non-Muslims in Saudi Arabia because 5 times a day they have to hear the Azan. Can you please turn it down?
Can you say that?
That will never take place in Saudi Arabia because it is a Muslim country.
Yes.
Sorry, it is an Islamic country.
Yeah.
Islam is practiced.
Yeah.
Saudi Arabia doesn't even, not Saudi Arabia actually, Islam doesn't even give right to this gentleman to enter Mecca. Yeah, and as well as doesn't even give this gentleman to practice what he wants to practice.
Mm.
Because of that, I haven't asked the question yet. Indonesia, it's not a Saudi Arabia, but it's a Muslim country where Sharia law is practiced part of the country. A Buddhist woman whom he feels is close as a religion. His sister is in prison because she turned down the Azam. People understood that as an insult to Islam. Islam is that untouchable. The moment you talk about anything linked with Islam, people will get rid of your head or people will put you in prison.
Mm.
You are laughing it. It is not funny.
It's not funny.
Woman
not funny.
Who is in her 40s, has a family, and her complaining was, I don't want to hear this Azan this loud. So you practice your freedom of movement and come to Britain. He can't practice his freedom of movement and go to Mecca.
But do you not see the difference? Yes? Yes.
When you go to Mecca, there is different visa.
Mecca is a city. Does he need a visa to go to Mecca? And will they give him visa to go to Mecca?
Sir, listen to the question.
Don't play with this silly game.
Don't play games about that.
Here's the thing.
Come on.
What will happen to me in an Islamic country if I say Muhammad is a false prophet, should put to death?
What will happen to me?
What will happen to me in Muslim country, in an Islamic country, if I say Muhammad is a false prophet, therefore he should put to death, according to Deuteronomy chapter 18?
What will happen? What would happen? Answer the question. Are you going to answer the question? Okay, he's talking to his mate.
أنا أقول الفيزا حق مكة Allah, which is the belief of God and Muhammad.
I am not talking about... Okay, so he says, you need a visa for Mecca, alongside...
You need a visa,
Anna. Believe in Allah, and then...
Muhammad is a visa. Is Shahada your visa?
Yes, to Mecca.
Oh, so Shahada is your official visa.
Yeah, but that's not heaven. Mecca is not heaven. Visa to heaven, maybe.
So go to Saudi Arabia, is Shahada your visa?
Yeah, according to him, yes.
You go to Mecca.
Mecca.
Sir, let me just express my concerns. Ali, listen carefully. I am expressing my concerns. I am concerned for non-Muslims who live in Muslim majority countries, as we just heard on the news this week, complaining about the azan, complaining about the volume of the call to prayer, will put you to prison because it is blaspheming according to Sharia law. I am concerned for non-Muslims who live in Muslim majority countries that they cannot practice their freedom of belief, which includes they want nothing to do with Islam. They cannot practice their freedom of expression, as well as they cannot practice their freedom of having dignity and value, because Islam takes it away. Thanks to teachings of Muhammad, thanks to teachings of Quran.
Yeah. And that's essentially what we have here. We have an ideology or a religion that's forced upon you. And the issue isn't so much about blasphemy, it's the fact that you disagree with any aspect to do with Islam. Anything that concerns you, any issues that it brings to your own personal life, if you express it in any way, then they want to shut you down because freedom of speech is non-existent. As my sister said, freedom of movement is not something of concern to Muslims. All they want you to do is say your Shahada and they'll shake your hands and that's the end of it. And what we want to call you to is God, who gives you a free choice, who gives you, who when you created all mankind, he gave us free will. And he says, choose you this day who you will serve. Who do you serve? Who will you choose this day? Because you have a choice. And what God is calling every man to do is to make the right decision, which is to choose his son, Jesus Christ, as their Lord and Savior. But he doesn't force you, he doesn't say to you, if you don't choose Jesus, he'll throw you in prison. If you don't choose Jesus, you cannot come to this part of the United Kingdom. He gives you that choice. And so we encourage every person, whether Muslim or atheist or from any part of the world, that you have access to God's Son through his sacrificial death on the cross. And you have a choice to make, whether you want to make heaven your home or hell your home. But it will not be forced upon you. Amen. We encourage you to come to Jesus. So, you're going.
As the teachings of Islam is dangerous for non-Muslims, as the teachings of Muhammad is dangerous for non-Muslims, it is only teachings of Lord Jesus Christ, whom gives you real freedom and whom offers you eternal life, joy and value and dignity and freedom through his son on the cross.
Yes. Amen. God bless.